Hi everyone, thanks for visiting my digital talk. I hope to see you all really soon in person again. So today I'll tell you more about remote pair programming tools. And to do this, we will follow a race. It's called the Tour de Remote Pair Programming. But first, before we are going to look into the tools and the race, I want to play a little game. This game is called Bingo. I think everyone knows Bingo. And it's called the Remote Pair Programming version. So in here on the bingo card, you see all kinds of quotes I've heard during a pair programming session using screen sharing. And I'm curious if you recognize some of them. So look for yourself if you can make a row of three or maybe even a full card. And unfortunately, I cannot ask you to raise your hand or to shout. So please do that for yourself. And you can always put it in the chat if you like to. So I've heard all those quotes and some more frequently than others. Like I think every session you hear, okay, can you see my screen? Do you see the IDE? But also I have sometimes the scroll person who scrolls like a lot up and down. And then every moment you want to read it, they're already going up or down again. So you have to ask every time like, okay, can you go a bit down or up? Yes, that's what I want to see. So these are the things I'm seeing during the pair programming. And later on, we're gonna check how it is with the tools. But first I want to tell you a little bit about myself. I'm Kaya Weers, I live in the Netherlands. I work at Ordina and I'm currently at assignment at the police. I play soccer. Currently not so much, but I hope to play matches soon. And I like to ride my motorbike if it's good weather. And I love animals. I'm both a cat and a dog person. I have only one cat now, but I hope to have a dog in the future sometimes. So we're going to talk about remote pair programming. Why remote? Yeah, of course, because everyone or most of us are working from home right now, are not in the office, and they don't have the option to sit next to someone else, and you have to do it remotely. And a lot of people use then screen sharing, but as you saw previously, it has the downsides. But first, let's go one step back. Why would you do pair programming at all? So pair programming really helps you to improve the code. You're already working with two persons at a time. You have discussions about how to set it up, what to use, which makes it better. It makes code reviews easier because people have seen it already before. So it's good for the code quality, but it's also good for your own knowledge. You learn a lot from each other, discussing parts, hearing new things. And it's also good for the communication. And especially in these days where we're all working from home, those pair programming sessions can also help to keep in contact with your colleagues and have a better understanding of each other. So why not the screen sharing? I know it's really easy because you're already using video share calling tools and then you just have to click on a button. But besides the quote in the bingo, there are a couple of things I don't like about it. For me, the biggest downside is the lack of interaction. It feels more like someone is presenting their code instead of that you're really collaborating together. Because someone shows it and goes through it, and it's not like you're working really together where someone else can grab the keyboard and type something. You can ask for control, of course, but that's mostly when you really have to do something and not just in the spur of the moment. So that's for me the biggest thing, but also the size of what you're sharing can be annoying. For example, I use a big monitor and a colleague of mine is using a small laptop screen. And if I then share my code, he cannot read it. And of course I can use presentation tools, but that doesn't make it easier, presentation mode. And also it can be a bit blurry, for example, you can have problems with performance. if the network isn't that well and someone is scrolling a lot, yeah, it can get blurry, and you don't have that with the tools mostly. So what are those tools? I decided to use to look at four of the tools, so four teams in this tour, because I had to make the pre-selection. There are so many tools, I cannot go over them all. And in the selection, I decided to focus on tools that are usable for multiple IDEs and multiple operating systems. For example, Visual Studio has a plugin called LiveShare, and I heard really good stories about it, but you can only use it for Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code. And for example, my team, a lot of people use IntelliA, so then it's not suitable. But if you have a team that is all using Visual Studio, please check it out, because I heard that it's also good and it works quite similar as some of the tools I'm discussing. And those tools, we're gonna look at how they perform on four different stages. The stages are about the environment you're working in as a participant, how you get access to the session, the options you have during a session, and the usability of the tools. And in the end of the tour, we will have one winner. But also, we have two jerseys to give away. And the jerseys are about a specific use case that one of the tools is really good in. So before we start, I have to make a little disclaimer. Those tools changed a lot, which is really good. They improved a lot last month. So it can be that one of the tools is already one version further. So I noted the version number so you can check out on which I base it upon. But let's continue. Go to the first team, which is GoTogether. GoTogether is a plugin for your IDE. You can use it for Eclipse, Visual Studio, and the JetBrains IDEs. As you see it here, I use it for IntelliA because that's what I'm using myself. To use it, you go to the GoTogether tab in your IDE, and from there you can start a session. This will generate an invitation URL, and you send that URL to the people you want to work with. They can then join using this URL in the browser or inside their IDE, what they want. And as they join, you join the project of the host. You go in their code, you can open files, you can change things, select parts, and all the changes will go to the Git branch of the host. So it will not go in your local changes. You all work on the code of the host. So this is the first team. Then we go to Team Pop. Team Pop used to be Screen. So the application recently changed their name. So it's good to know if you know Screen, that's currently Pop. So this is an application, not a plugin, and you can use it on desktop, mobile, and web. As a host, you need to download the application. You cannot use the browser version, and you start a session. If you start a session, it generates a URL or a code, and you can give that to the people you want to participate. This application from all the tools looks the most like traditional screen sharing, because you're sharing the screen and then you give the participants control. Only here, all the participants have control by default. So everyone is be able to click and type at any time, but only one person at a time. And also it includes video calling, a chat, and the option to draw on the screen. Then the next team is Team GoToAdMe. GoToAdMe is a plugin for the JetBrains IDEs. It's developed by them also. And also here you have a button to start a session. If you start a session, it generates a URL and you can send that to the participants. And they have to download the IntelliA client. So instead of their using their own IntelliA, they have to use the client, because the client has a connection to the code of the host. So you have to use that, but it looks and feels a lot like your normal IntelliA, as you will see in this screenshot. And then it opens again the project of the host. So you're totally in the code of the host, and all the changes you make go to their version control. And yeah, you have the same options like in the previous tools. You can type, select, open files. And Code.me also has now video calling and chat included. You can also turn it off, but if you want, you can use it and you don't need a separate video calling tool. The last theme is Theme GitLive. GitLive is again a plugin for your IDE. You can use it for the JetBrains IDEs and for Visual Studio. And it works a little bit different than the previous tools because this one is not only for pair programming. It's really a tool for like collaborating in code all day. As the creators call it, it's a collaboration platform for developers. And I totally agree with them because it's way more than just one session. You can all day see what your colleagues are working on. So how do you start? You log in with your version control system. It can be GitHub, GitLab, Azure, all those tools are supported. And then you log in on a certain repository. And then you will see all the colleagues who are also using GitLive and have access to that repository. So as you see on the left bottom corner, you see Kaya Weers and Kaya Test, and are both two different persons in that repository. And you can see what they are working on, that they make changes and in which file. So that's what you will see all the time. And besides that, you can set up a call with someone. And during that call, it's possible to do a code share. And then you're going to like some pair programming session where you go inside the code of the one who asked you to do that. And that's how you do the pair programming. We will go to the details later on, but now you already have an idea of what's possible in GitLive. Now let's go to our first stage. This one is about the coding environment. And then I mean the coding environment for the participants, because the host is always coding in their own environment. In CodeTogether and GitLive, people work in their own IDE. And in CodeTogether, it's also possible to join via the browser. And Code.me, as I just explained, you're not using your own IntelliA, but you're using the client to have the connection to the host. So it feels like IntelliA, but it's slightly different. And then we have POP. And as POP is more like regular screen sharing, you're just working in everything that the host is working. So you will work in the IDE the host is working in. The winner of this stage is CodeTogether. Because in CodeTogether, you can just work in your own IDE, which is really handy with all the shortcuts you have. And also you can join in the browser, for example, if you don't have an IDE which is supported. So you will see the interim score and the yellow bike CodeTogether is now first. And then the pink bike is GitLive, which is second. Our second stage is about the access you have to the session. And there are two parts. So how do you get access to the session? But also, is it possible to have any restrictions so that not everyone can join your session because you're sharing code that might not be allowed for everyone to see? So those are the two parts I'm going to talk about. So first, how do you get to the session? In all the tools except for GitLive, you use the invitation URL. So the host starts a session and gives the URL to the participant and then they can join. In GitLive, you use that version control system to log on and everyone who is logged on to GitLive can do a call together. And in that call, you can choose to share your code. And then the other people can work with you together in your code. So that's how you start a session there by a call. And then about the restrictions. Let's start with the easiest one. POP doesn't offer any options to restrict the access. So everyone with the URL can join your session. And there's also no way to kick someone out. You have to stop the session if people doing things you don't like. Because with POP, people have access to your whole machine. They can do lots of stuff. So I think it's a shame that they didn't make an option to restrict anything. Then in Code Together and Code With Me, you can accept people before they get in. So even though they have the URL, the moment they get in, you can still accept them and to make sure you have the right person in your call. Then also you have in both of the tools some options to say what they are allowed to do. Those options are more extensive in Code With Me. So in Code With Me, you can also determine if they are using the terminal, if they are allowed, which files you can make certain files hidden that are not allowed to see or touch them. There are way more options to determine what people are allowed to do. And also it is possible to kick someone out of the session. So you, even though you accepted them, you can later on say, no, okay, I don't want you in this session anymore. And then Git Live works, of course, differently because you're already logged in with your version control system. So in Git Live, it can be a disadvantage that only people with access to the repository can join your pair programming session. But it also is really secure because only people should be allowed to see the repository can join the call and no one else. And this makes that this stage doesn't have a winner. Git Live and Code With Me finish at exactly the same time. Git Live does better in the security because it only allows people from the repository. And Code With Me, is more flexible because you can do it with people who don't have access and it still has a lot of options to restrict access. So then we go to our next interim score, the green bike. Code With Me is now second, together with Code Together, the yellow one. And the pink one, Git Live, is first. And POP is quite sad, still at the start. The next stage is about pair programming options. So which options do you have when you're inside the session? Code Together and Code With Me are quite similar again. So they both give you the option to pretend like your real pair programming where you're having one keyboard and one mouse. So if you do that, every change someone makes or every file the other one clicks, you will go to that part too. So it will switch for every change, just like you're allowed to work with one person at a time. But also it gives you the options to work parallel on the host. So if the host is working on one file, you can open another file, make some changes, or just look at the code and then choose to follow the host again. And I think this is really helpful because of course, normally you wouldn't have that option, but it really helps that if I just want to check one thing or if I just didn't get the time to read something and the other one already moved on, then you can do that for a second without disturbing the other person, or maybe you're coding with the whole group and then you don't have to disturb everyone. So I think that those extra options are really helpful. And yeah, they're calling it a bit different, but they have, it looks quite similar. And then Code With Me has some more options, especially for the participant, because the participant is allowed to run the tests. And then everyone will see those tests, start the application and use the terminal. And those options are in Code Together only for the presenter. And this is really a shame because, for example, for debugging, it would really help if everyone could collaborate. And in Code With Me, that's a really good option. They really made debugging perfectly together because everyone will see everything. But you're also, everyone is allowed to put a breakpoint, can see the details in the debugger. They really did a brilliant job for that. So I think that's why I would alone already choose Code With Me. But let's first continue with the other tools. GoTogether did just develop a Teams, which is the paid version of it. And in there you can add people, and with those people, then they are, for example, allowed to write in the terminal. But still, it's more minimal in sense of what you see from what the other one is doing. It's more separated. Then we go to POP. And in POP, you can do whatever the host can. Because it's more like just screen sharing with access, you do and see everything that the host is seeing. So you work in their application and what they have on their machine. And I think this is the best pre-2020 imitation, but still it doesn't win this stage. And that's because I think that it's a shame to not make pair programming better and more efficient. Now we have to do it remotely. And I think that it really helps that you can, for 1 second, check a file, and you don't have to take all the others to another file to do that. And then we have Git Live. Git Live works a bit different because you stay in your own code. So in the other tools, you go to the code of the host, to their branch, totally switch. And in Git Live, you also stay in your own code, and you can make your changes in your for your own local changes. And as you see here, there's one file opened both in the participant's own code, and the right one is from the host. And that in that way, you can, if you make a change either in the one or in the other, determines in which branch you're making the change. And also in there, if you do the work in the host file, you have the option to follow the host or to work for yourself in their files. So that's a bit similar as GoTogether and CodeWithMe. And for debugging in Git Live, it's a little bit in between CodeWithMe and CodeTogether, because you cannot see what the others are doing. So if someone is running the test, you won't see it in Git Live. But everyone is possible to run the test. So you can do it, but the others won't see it. But what if you want to debug together, then you want to see it. So the little workaround you can do is to follow the cursor of someone, and then they are going to do a debugging, and then you will go through the code with the other one. You only won't see the details of it. So that's how you can solve it a little bit. So it won't come as a surprise that CodeWithMe won this stage. It has so many options for the pair programming. And besides that, the debugging is just amazing. So that's why they really won this stage. And because of this win, they are on the first place together with Git Live. So the green and the pink one are now first. And yeah, POP is still really sad in the beginning. We go to our last and final stage, which is about usability. And the first thing I checked was the code completion, because I don't want to type everything out. I want the IDE to fix that for me. And for nearly all the tools, that works perfectly. The only thing I could find is that CodeTogether, in this case, didn't complete with the brackets included. So the new error list you see, that's the one I completed, but it only types the text. It doesn't add the brackets, and the other tools do. But that's it's a minor detail. And now let's see what the tools have in sense of extras. What is possible besides the regular stuff? And if you look at POP, it has the chat and the video, but the most important feature here is that it's possible to draw. So you can draw on the screen. As you see here, you can circle something, you can point to something, make lines, whatever you want. But you can also open a separate canvas and draw in there. And that's, for me, I think that's really a big plus, because you can have a short discussion in the middle of your pair programming session about architecture, how things fit together. And that's, I think, really easy to do like this. There are, of course, a lot of tools to do it too, but I think this is more that you do it just a minute instead of starting a whole new tool. Then Code with Me also has a video and chat function now. And they also have a private chat so that you can just talk with one person in case you're having a session with multiple. But then we go to Git Live. Git Live has the most extras of all. I already told you about that. It's more like a collaboration tool instead of only for pair programming. And that's what all the features are about. So you can see what your colleagues made for changes. You can directly cherry pick your changes if you see something. But for me, the most brilliant feature is the notification of merge conflicts. As you see the small red bar in the left, that's that you know that you made a change that is conflicting with someone else's change. As you see here, both of the people changed the main method name, or it was main and it's now the main method and a new name. And that's of course conflicting and it will notify you for that. I think that's brilliant that you see it during coding and not in the end. And then it also has integration with tools like Slack and Jira, and you can turn it off. So if you're getting crazy about that everyone can see you and follow and do see what you're doing, you can turn it off for a while to work more in peace. So it wouldn't be a surprise that Git Live wins this stage. I think they have brilliant options for collaboration, especially well when everyone is not at the office. So you really have option to see what others are working on. And also that makes the final score a win for Git Live. So Git Live has won the Tour de Remote Pair Programming, and Code with Me is second, Code Together is third, and Pop has finally left the start, but still got lost in this tour. So yeah, as already told, Git Live has tons of extras which are really helpful, but also the pair programming works good. So I think that's a really good tool with only one disadvantage, which can be either really big or really small, depending on how you're using it. Only people with access to the repository can join your session. So if you're using it with your colleagues, they probably have access and it's no problem. If you're using it with people outside your team or company, it can be a huge problem because you cannot use it at all. And then I would advise you to use it, Code with Me, which also has tons of options inside the pair programming session. So it's also a really good tool to use. So let's go to our final part about the jerseys. So the jerseys are about a use case in which a certain tool is really good. And Pop just won a jersey. So you see that even if it got lost, it's good in one thing. So what is it? So I called it more than code. We now look at using those tools in your IDE. So how does it work if you're working in your IDE and how can you share that part with your colleagues? But what if you're working in a separate terminal or in the browser, if you're doing frontend and you want to see how it looks, or Word or whatever, any other program, you cannot use those other tools. And Pop can be used, and then you have still the options to that everyone has access directly, control access and drawing. So then I would advise you to use Pop. And then the Debugging Together jersey, not surprisingly, is going to Code with Me. Yeah, I would really advise you to look into that if you like to do debugging together. It works really smoothly. So here you see that still, even though Git Live was really the winner, that depending on the situation, it might be suitable to use another tool. So I would really advise you to try it out, because it depends on your situation, but also what does your employer support? Do you want to do things on premise? Yeah, let's dive into if you're interested. But most important for me is that you're using a tool. Just try one of those tools, use it, because those tools will make it easier to do pair programming, which will make it more fun, and which will make sure that you're doing it more often. And especially from working from home, I think it's really important to do pair programming more often. And it's just easier with this, you get less frustrated and you want to do it as much as you can, I think. So thank you for your attention. I hope that you want to try some of the tools, and please let me know if you tried already one, or if you're going to, what you think of it, and what were the downsides and the good parts about it. I'm really looking forward to hear about that. Thank you.